Our canvas is now working pretty well, so it's time for our heart to show up. The first piece of art we are going to have are our nodes. In the final result, they are the boxes that contain the dialog data and connections. We'll be separating the nodes in three different files, two of which will be the node types and one will be the base node. For the node types, we have a single choice node and a multiple choice node. The only difference between them are the choices and the add choice button. The single choice node is basically a way of saying press continue to go to the next dialog, while the multiple choice node is a way of saying choose the option to go to the next dialog. Both will be divided into their own classes, the S single choice node and the S multiple choice node. For the data that they hold equal though, we are going to create the base class named DS node. Both of the other nodes will end up inheriting from this one. Let's start this off by going back to our dialog system folder and create a new folder named elements. Inside, we'll create a new C# script to which I'll name DS node. Opening it up, feel free to remove the default methods and swap the inheritance from MonoBehavior to node. Import the necessary namespace for the node class, and I'll make it part of the elements sub namespace. We'll be declaring our common data here as well draw the UI that both nodes have in common. If we look at our final nodes, we can see the following data. The dialog name, the add button, the dialog choices, the dialog text, and the dialog type, single or multiple. From all of those, the differences are the add button, the way they lay out the choices, and the type, which uses the same variable, so it's a common thing. Our final variable should then be dialog name, dialog choices, dialog text, and dialog type. Because in object-oriented programming languages, public variables are often seen as try to not do it, I'll be using properties instead. However, this might work better due to my Unity version that I believe is a higher C# version. So I'll be able to use the fill serialize field in the automatic properties. If you can't and you need to create the private variables, consider yourself what you'd prefer to do. Many people use public variables in scriptable objects and such, but go as you prefer. This works in my version, so I'll go with the automatic properties instead. So let's go ahead and create them. Type in public string dialog name with an uppercase first letter and do an automatic property. Unity seems to use properties but not put the uppercase first letter. But I believe in C# it is a common thing to do, so I'll follow that. We will not name this name because Visual Elements already have a variable named name which is used for style sheets. For our choices, we are gonna make them a list. By doing this, we can iterate through them in the specific node script and lay them out in the UI the way we want to. So type in public list, and for now we'll make it a list of strings and name it choices. Of course, we'll do the same for our text variable. For our type, we'll need to create an enumeration. Let's do that by going to our assets folder and creating a new folder named dialog system. We'll be keeping our non-editor scripts here so that if you were to ever import this in any other project, it will have no conflicts with existing files. Inside, we'll create yet another folder named enumerations. And in here, we'll create a new C# script called DSDialogType. Open it up, and here we'll of course remove the default code and remove the MonoBehavior inheritance. We'll make this an enum instead of a class, and the only values this enumeration is going to have for now is single choice and multiple choice, so go ahead and type that in. I'll make it part of the enumeration sub-namespace. Back in our Node script, we'll import the enumerations namespace and create a new automatic property of type dsDialogType, which shall name DialogType because a class named type already exists, and because I type in properties with an uppercase at the beginning, it will kinda feel like I will be calling that class. We'll be initializing the variables with the default value and we'll be doing it in a method named initialize. So type in public void initialize, and the reason why I'm making this in a method instead of a constructor is because we can call this whenever we want, but mainly because I'm going to use the activator class later on to instantiate the nodes and I'm not entirely sure if you can easily pass in parameters with it. Inside, we'll set the dialog name to be dialog name with no spaces. This will be the name of the scriptable object of the dialog at the end. We'll also initialize the choices list, and the text to be dialog text. We'll not be setting the type here as they are different depending on the node script. Now that's done, so let's add this node in our graph view. Head back to the graph view script and create a method named createNode and call it in the constructor for now. Inside this method, we'll create a variable of type dsNode, which I'll name Node. We then use the GraphViewAddElement method to add our node. The AddElement method is the same as the Add method, but for graph elements, which elements from the GraphView API inherit from. If we save and go to Unity, we shall now see an empty node showing up in the window.